Et demi-terre. Gloria in excelsis et
Largire nobis quae sumus Domine semper spiritum cogitanti quae regata sunt propitius et ad genedi. Ud cui sine te se non possumus, secundum te vivere valeamus. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te cum vivit et regnat in unitate spiritus sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus. Deus omnium fidelium pastor et regitor famulum tuum Franciscum, quem pastorem ecclesiae tuae presse voluisti propitius respice, da ei quae sumus verbo et exemplo quibus preest proficere, ut ad vitam una cum grege sibi credito perveniat sempiternam. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Thank you.
vobis. Sequentia sancti evangelii secundum Lucam. In illo tempore, dixit Iesus discipulis suis parabulam hanc, homo quidam erat dives, qui habebat vinicum, et hic diffamatus est apud illum, quasi dissipasset bona ipsius. Et vocavit illum et ait illi, quid hoc audio dete, Rederationem villicationis turim, iam enim non poteris villicare. Ait autem villicus in trasem, quid faciam quia dominus meus auferta me villicationem. Fodere non valeo mendicare rubem, Scio quid faciam, ud cum modus fuero a villicatione, recipiant me in domus suas. Convocatis itaque singulis debitoribus domini sui, dicevat primo, quantum debes domino meo. At ille dingsit, centum cados olei. Digesit quae illi, accipe cautionem tuam. Ed esse decito scribe quinquaginta. Deinde ali digesit, tu vero quantum debes. Qui ait centum coros tritici. Ait illi, accipe literas tuas, et scribe octoginta. Et laudavit Dominus villicum iniquitatis, quia prudenter fecisset, quia filiuius seculi prudentiores filii suis in generatione suas. Et ego vobis dicum, facite vobis amicos de mammona iniquitatis, ut cum defeceritis, recipiant vos in eterna tabernacula.
Thank you. the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Dear community members, dear sisters, and my dear brethren, I'm sure you all remember that every first Friday here in this church, Holy Mass is offered for the benefactors. We remind you that so that we can pray for them. Today, I renew this wish by asking you to pray for the benefactors. So when benefactors means, comes from Latin, benefacere, we pray for all those who do us good, all those who help us, all those who support us. By supporting, sometimes we reduce that to something only financial, which is important, of course. It's a great act of charity to support some charities, to support people in need, to support religious communities who work for the glory of God, for the service of your souls, and who also have some bills to pay and have to survive in this difficult world. So the finances are important. I do not neglect that. But I do not neglect as well all the benefactors, all those who come here to this church and who help. They are great benefactors, some of them sing in the choir, some of them play the organ, other ones would prepare the flowers, other ones would again help us clean the church or be available for many different tasks. And we also have these great, and only God knows how many, spiritual, only spiritual benefactors, people who just come here and pray, and do support us by praying, by opening their hearts to God. We think about people who come here, we also think about all the thousands of viewers, subscribers who follow our ceremonies, and who are united to us through the live stream, and who also are but one in the spirit of prayer. And among all those who support us spiritually, they are of course the female branch of the Institute of Christ the King, the Sister Adorers of the Royal Heart of Jesus Christ, Sovereign Priest. Four of these sisters are today with us. They support us spiritually. We must always be assured of their prayers. And they are always close to us through prayer, but today they are close to us physically. And as you know, throughout their life, prayer is really their first job. If we had to explain just in a few words what a sister adorer is, well, it's kind of simple. She's a sister, she's a nun, that means a lady who consecrated her life to God, to the church, who became a bride of Christ, and who is an adorer, that means she dedicated her life to adoration, adore Almighty God. This is their first job. That's why all our sisters throughout their convents and houses in Europe and in the United States, their first apostolate is really to adore God, to give God praise, to praise Him, and to pray for the priest, pray for the sanctification of priests. This is why every day they spend time in prayer before the Blessed Sacrament, and when they do not pray and only take time for adoration and contemplation, they pray in a different manner by offering all their daily actions of their community life. So, my dear brethren, of course, we all know that we live in a very strange world, as we often hear now, in challenging times, in difficult times, all with lots of worries. We hear a lot of complaints, a lot of fear. And I always remind people, be optimistic, be confident in God's grace. God always protects us. Our Lady always protects us, intercedes for us. And we should never forget that at all. We all know about all the current difficulties, but there are many, many reasons for being optimistic, for being grateful, for being focused on what is good, what is uplifting. Don't be defeatist. Be winners. So we must always thank God, and thank God as our sisters do in their prayers. We thank God for, of course, all the newly ordained priests who were ordained this year. We thank God for the vocations. We thank God for all the Catholic families. And we thank God, especially today, from the deepest part of our heart, for this little drop in the sea with this beautiful community of the Sister Adorers of the Royal Heart. The sisters have, as you know, they have already come here to Ireland a good number of times, always as a guest, only for a few days. And as you know, earlier in the year, thank God, they have acquired a very beautiful property in County Louth in Ardee, which is a former convent of Mercy, where they have already come a few times, and they will soon be permanently resident there and soon have their community life. So today, if we had to, I would like just to tell you another few words about their vocation, so that you never feel alone, and you always remember in your prayers when you struggle, when times are difficult, when you need some comfort and encouragement. Think, remember that the sisters, the nuns, are praying for you, they are praying for us. I must tell you, as a priest, I often think about that, and this is very, it gives me a lot of strength, a lot of grace, a lot of energy, I would say, as a priest. We should never forget this female branch of our community. They were founded in 2001, and their main vocation, as I was saying, is really to render present the adoration of God here in this world, which is far from God. So the first place given in their community life is really adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, to pray to Almighty God, to pray for the sanctification of priests, and to make the kingdom of His Royal Heart shine forth on all those they meet. You see that their choir habit, actually their religious habit, describes on a very powerful manner what they are exactly. The blue color that they wear on their cope means the Salesian, the spirit of Saint Francis de Sales, first of all, and also the fact that they are consecrated, like all members of our community, to the Immaculate Conception. And this spirit of Saint Francis de Sales is very important because they live in this spirituality, and it's really a spirit of humility towards God, a spirit of meekness towards all their neighbors. And so that in all things, the sisters work, the sisters pray, the sisters are also present in some of our apostolates, and they do everything in this spirit of humility and spirit of meekness towards our neighbor, remembering these words, that all is by love, in love, for love, and with love in Holy Church. So, wherever the sisters are living their community life, in all their houses, now they are spread in different countries, in Switzerland, in Italy, in Germany, in United Kingdom, in the States, and as well as very soon here in Ireland. And all over their houses, we can really say that Jesus is at the center of their life. In each one of their houses, their convents, the chaplain not only is available for Holy Mass and for confessions and for spiritual direction, but he exposes the Blessed Sacrament every morning, and throughout the day, Jesus is adored. One of the sisters, all the sisters would take turn to be present in front of the Blessed Sacrament throughout the day, and there they would pray. They would pray and adore Jesus in really present in his body, his blood, his soul, his divinity in the Holy Eucharist. And we know with this great devotion to the Sacred Heart, how during this time of prayer they can console him for all the negligence of men. We know how it's during this time that they can make known all our needs to him. During this time as well that they can beg the graces from him, from others, from ourselves, for others. And you will see, they will certainly be happy to greet you after Holy Mass today, that the whole habit really is an expression on how they are consecrated to God and how their body actually is really fully covered, kind of hidden, which is an expression of being totally beyond. They belong to Christ, they belong to our Lord. And on the veil, they will explain that better than me, the veil is fixed on their choir, on their habits, with five needles that really signify the five holy wounds of our Lord. So when we think about nuns, sometimes I know, especially here in Ireland, you would think about elderly people who are running in the world and thinking about the past. Actually, our sisters are really, their first duty is to live in a community, as I have already described, and they are not cloistered, it means they are not bound to live in a certain location, but they will be assigned to different convents throughout their life. And even when they live their community life, they also have a time for an apostolate. It means to help the priest in their apostolates. So according to the different locations, the nuns, the sisters would either teach in the schools, which is the case in Preston, in the United Kingdom. They could also receive the pilgrims or help them in a retreat center. They could also lead some summer camps, as it was the case in Ardee during the week. They could also visit the sick or give catechism lessons. So there are many ways, many expressions of these apostolates on how they can help the priest. So today I would just like to thank God publicly again, and also on your behalf, dear brethren, let us always be optimistic. Let us always be very grateful for this community. I would like to renew all my profound gratitude to the sisters, adorers of the Royal Heart, for their prayerful life. Thank you, dear sisters, for coming to Ireland for good. Thank you for visiting sunny Limerick today. Thank you for singing the Gregorian chant today. Thank you for playing the violin as well during Holy Mass. You know that the sisters are now composed by almost 60 sisters, and five of them are Irish. Their presence is also the occasion of taking a second collection to benefit their community. So again, during Holy Mass, there will be the normal collection, but the collection that will be taken at the back of the Mass will benefit the sister adorers. Please be generous. Thank you again for all your help. Dear sisters, we wish you to keep really advancing well and simply where and when God calls you, where he wills. Dear sisters, always have great confidence in God, serving him in his church with the charism of your community. Keep being faithful daughters of the church and bride of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Credo in unum et Deum.
Patrem omnipotentem, factorem celi et terrae, visibilium omnium et invisibilium.
Thank you. De Romania secula seculo. Dominus vobis. Sursum corda. Gratia saga. Vere dignum et justum est, ecum et salutare. Nos tibi sempere et ubique gratia sarangere. Domine sancte pater omnipotens aeterne Deus, cui cum unigenito filio tuo et spiritus sancto unus est Deus, unus est Domine. Non in unio singularitate personae, sed in unius trinitate substantiae. Quod enim de tua gloria revelamat et credimus, hoc de filio tuum, hoc de spiritus sanctum, sine differentia discretionis sanctimus. Ut in confessione vere sempiterne cui deitatis, et in personis proprietas, et in essentia unitas, et in majestate adoretur equalitas, quam laudant angeli ad quae arcangeli, cherubim quoque ac seraphim, qui non cessant clamare quotidie una voce dicente.
Amen.
per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus, per receptis salutaribus monitim, et divina in institutione formati, audemus dicere. Pater noster, qui et in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in celo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis odie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimitimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Miseria tu vestri omnipotens Deus, dimissis peccatis vestris, peducat vos et vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum vestrorum, tribuat vobis omnipotens et misericors Dominus.
Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccatam mundi, Domine non sum dignus, qui pres rectum meum, satan cum diabolus, maestor anima mea. Domine non sum dignus, qui pres rectum meum, satan cum diabolus, maestor anima mea. Domine non sum dignus, qui pres rectum meum, satan cum diabolus, maestor anima mea. Dominus
Sit nobis Domine reparatio mentis et corporis celeste mysterium, ut cuius exequimur cultum sensiamus effectum, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus. Ec nos quae sumus Domine divini sacramenti perceptio protegat, et famulum tuum Franciscum, quem pastorem ecclesiae tuae prece voluisti, una cum commisso sibi regge salvet semper et muniat. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen. Dominus vobis.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus,
Pater et Filii